Yo, how y'all doing? PSA, PSA. If you haven't seen Retribution yet, go click that link and watch it. This video will be a potential spoiler, and we don't want to ruin the movie for anybody. So starting out from filming, of course, we before then we had to get the equipment set up. So before then, we were getting gear straight. We were getting the Airbnb that we had actually wrote the movie for, and we got that just in time. And we shot the movie, I think, in what, like two days? Yeah. The first day we got there, we told we had the cast rehearsed in person and get their connection. And after that, we planned with them to kind of branch off and try to break the ice a little bit. This was their first time meeting in person. So really having them connect instantly off the bat was amazing.
It's crazy how the chemistry came through. Like, yeah, we were on FaceTime calls, but it's different when you're in front of a person and that you don't know, you haven't been around them before. So it was just crazy to see how good everybody came together so quickly. Like, it was just perfect.
So, do pop culture. I'm scared. Pop culture. We're good at that type of stuff. We're women.
Yeah. But y'all, you're losing.
Facts. Oh, yeah.
So after we finished writing the script, we initially, when you find the actors, when actors that not even that you're paying for, so you work on what you have. So right now we had to get some of our group of friends and people that we knew from here and there to hop in the process for us. And the way that we had got everybody together was, you know, due to COVID, we had everybody hop on business calls and have them see how they were with their lines and see if they were right for their lines. And over the time, we found a good amount of people, but some people that, you know, not everybody can act when you have a super group of friends. So.
And it was kind of tough through the process of trying to find actors, because you'll get somebody to say, hey, I want to do it, I'm excited, and then they'll just drop. And, you know, that was very hard for us, because at the time, you know, we was kind of in a time crunch. But, you know, I just want to thank everybody who was a part of the cast, because, you know, they were committed from day one. You know, we already had told them, hey, you guys not sure you want to do this, let us know now, because, you know, we had people drop and we're going to make magic. So, you know, I said, I just want to thank everybody who joined, from Star, Zay, Yamini, Cherish, Trail,
Dime.
I want to thank everybody, because, hey, like, just look at Retribution, and just we made a good film, and, you know, our dreams came true with this film. So I just want to thank everybody for helping us with the process, you know, working with us, and just want to thank you guys.
Trey, get that damn camera out my face.
Right, that's what I was saying, yeah. God damn it. Fuck.
It's a rare condition this day and age to read any good news on the newspaper.
Starting day one, we were trying to start in the morning and make sure we get everybody in different cars. So, like how we wrote in the script, we had all the boys in one car. But and a way to make it seem like they were really driving, we got a green screen set outside the window. And there was no way we could have had the camera while they were really driving. So we just had to roll with it with the green screen and really try to fake it, really have them acting like they're really driving. And all the different angles, from his angle outside the window to putting it on this side and rotating the green screen from the other. And the same thing with the girls too, doing the same thing for them.
Hey, you good?
And I think later on, we had the time to get everybody together to really have their interviews and really talk about how they feel for the movie and how they think the process and the outcome of the movie would be.
And yeah, I can say it was a long process during the day to shoot them scenes, but you know, everything came together pretty well, you know. The car scene was amazing, first of all. The girls killed it. Killed it, you know. Guys, we did our thing too, but I was really proud of what the girls did because, you know, like I said, they never really been together before, but the way they performed, it was like they knew each other for years, so that was perfect. What scene was it after that? The house scene, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Them walking in and setting that stuff down. Setting, and
yeah.
All the girls really connecting with each other and everybody yeah, conversating.
That was perfect. We did have to try trouble with the lighting at first, though, mm-hmm. right inside.
Yeah. Yeah. So the way we had did with certain round with the lighting is make sure we had different angles. Also, this is our first time really setting up and getting everything in this Airbnb and making sure we have all the angles that we had straight.
Among the dead, Layla Hunter, one of Sunnyside's first adopters, most notably known for her artistic painting talents, as she was also becoming very popular on social media.
Ambriana, Ambriana Sporel. I go by Bria, and I run Art by Ambriana. I'm originally from King William, Virginia, but right now I go to Radford University, so I kind of bounce between the two areas. I've been kind of doodling since I was a little kid. I grew up and I wanted to be a cartoon artist, and I just switched over to music. So I started playing a bunch of instruments like saxophone and all. Then when I turned 14, I got my first job as a caricature artist at King's Dominion. So I was drawing people. I ended up doing body art, a little bit of photography, but more so on the art. And then I kind of went back into the music side. I was really serious about music at one point, and I don't know what happened, but last year, right before the pandemic, I just kind of really dove into what I truly love at heart, honestly. So I just kind of went back to it, and I'm glad I did. I mean, I love the idea of collabing with people, and what other way to do that? Like, I honestly, when you reached out, I was like, this is a great idea. And I'm kind of upset that I didn't think of something like that before now. Like, yeah. And I definitely couldn't say no to that opportunity.
So how did you feel seeing your artwork just on the big screen?
Oh, I love it. It was lit. It was so lit. Me and my family, when we were watching it, my family was all like, that's you. Like, look at you. And I'm like, I know it's me. I made it. Like, and then, I mean, even the other day when my friends are watching it, they were like, run that back. We had to pause the whole thing and run it back just so they could see it again.
Watch more on the robbery at the Blessing House earlier this morning.
Go ahead, see what you
like,
say.
That already, like, bruh, like, I'm sorry, but I just, you can go ahead. I'm gonna shut up, I promise.
This took me some shit to edit, because all that is all me.
Mm-hmm.
So that took, like, I think a couple of days to try to recreate a whole room and create the lights and the whole thing. I created all of this.
Did you have to, like, hold the camera just at a TV and then, like, somehow cut the, like, like, huh?
That's all edited. I had my uncle on the green screen. The thing is, when I called him to do the project, of course, he was really excited.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, he called me during the day and he forgot that, oh, damn, they had a party the same night.
Oh.
So he had to sit up front. Everybody was in the back, but you could hear it a little bit in the background of everybody yelling in the back.
But y'all got it done because I would not have known until you told me.
So I had to get all the lights and stuff and him on the green screen. It took him like, I think, 30 minutes to an hour to learn his lines. He had like a whole bunch of lines.
So, yeah. Honestly, yeah, he had like a whole monologue, low-key. Yeah, like,
he loved it. He liked
later this evening. Also, so you can hear want to back. Remind all of our viewers of today's tragic
that's crazy.
That's the first time
I've ever seen it. I never noticed it.
Me either. That's crazy.
I think it actually helps, though, because that silence going into the other part where it's like, oh shit, what did he just say? Yeah. Like, definitely helps give that effect some more.
Among the dead, Layla Hunter, one of Sunnyside's first adopters. Most notably known for her artistic painting talents.
Period.
Yeah, that's a dope painting to me because, I don't know, it's just, just look at it. It's so many different meanings that could come out of this.
After you sent us the other ones, I was like, okay, these cool. But when I seen it, I was like, that's the definition of this movie. We gotta have that. Exactly. Exactly. And I don't know if y'all can see that real clearly, but right there, what she's painting on is purely green. But I copied that.
Oh, see, and I wouldn't have known that at all.
Yeah, so I had to green screen the painting.
And you really had that angle perfect.
Exactly. And what would be your inspiration behind this painting?
Okay, so this painting, I don't know how to describe this. And this is like me being indecisive is a bit of this painting. Like me not even knowing how to describe that is the painting itself. It's just always this, should I say this? Should I say that? Should I do this? Should I do that? Like in life, you really just have to make decisions, all of that. I can't even choose a word. Like, so it's like, you know, which part of you do you want to follow? Do you want to follow your heart? Do you want to follow your brain? Like a lot of that is represented as like vertical, but I just want it to be different.
She was also becoming very popular on social.
You from right there.
Okay. When I peeped this, I was like, now how the fuck? I was in my head, I was like, can he put a check mark on my account? Does that work that way?
Yeah, so I had found a site where it's like you can create like a picture of an Instagram account, not an actual account.
Yeah.
So like right there it was like if you wanna like say you wanna fake or verify it or whatever, I was like, okay, add that on there.
Dang.
Yeah, so it's, I wanted from what we wrote in the script was, okay, she grew very popular on social media at her time at this group home. And her friends got jealous, and that's why they pulled that prank on her.
Yeah.
And then I had to, you know, fake it, so I created this little fake.
And I mean, honestly, you did that, especially with the inquiry. It's like, you know, commissions open. Like,
that. I had to try to, like, look around and see, like, what can I do to make this look realistic?
Mm-hmm. Hey, yo, turn this off.
This tragedy reminds us all that our time is limited, and we must take every opportunity.
And look. I don't know, you really did that.
So this scene right here where Star is talking to Diamond, I wanted her to actually walk around so my character can make his move across his crush in the movie. So what I did was have her walk around the counter while they were talking, had them, my character, to reenact the scene in her face. Okay, she's sitting there alone, let me go try to talk to her. Had my character pan around and right here with different angles, it was certain angles that I couldn't get from mine because of the blinding light from behind. So what I did was I put the camera from behind the counter and had our character, what was her name, Crystal, have her walk through and talk to her and to get her to come outside and another character to walk around to get something and have him also in the background in the mirror, not everybody else.
This scene right here, Montreal scene, when he came in and act toxic, this was probably one of the funniest scenes of just me knowing him, like, as my little brother, me knowing, like, this is how he is, like. So it was just cool to see him, you know what I'm saying, reenact his part.
It's gonna take a couple.
Campfire scene, one of my favorite scenes of the whole movie.
Now, the process with the campfire scene was trying to get the fire to start. That was pretty much most of the whole problem that we had, that we kept trying for like probably like a few hours trying to get the fire to start. None of us knew how to do it.
That was like, you know, because it had rained a couple days, so at the Airbnb, it was a fire pit, but everything in the fire pit was damp.
Yeah, so I came up with the idea to have an LED, like, have it flicker in certain ways and try to fake a fire using CGI. And also sometimes when the fire did start in certain ways, I used parts of that to in certain different angles, but the rest I had to fake the fire and also use that light.
The goat man.
Hey, yo, y'all trying to tell scary stories?
No.
Fuck nah.
No, you drunk.
In this scene, it was just monumental because I want to give a shout out to Zay. The way you told this story at the campfire scene, man, it was so perfect. It was perfect, man.
I liked it because it really kept me interested in the story, like the really backstory to them thinking, oh yeah, like go ahead and tell us a story. You're drunk, this might be funny. And to them realizing like, oh, this is something that actually happened, like this was a traumatic event that really happened.
And him being drunk and the goofy character he was, he kind of made fun of it. So that's why it was perfect for his character too.
And at the same time towards this was the scene with you and Star upstairs. And it's like, at the same time, he's telling the story and also something else is going on right now at the same moment. And nobody even realized.
Almost like he summoned the ghost.
But the scene with Jay and Star, what I did was I had his character try to make way out of the scene for a moment. And the character of, the ghost coming back and coming for Star was pretty much making her mark, letting her know that she is there.
She's sorry you had to be the first, but hey, it's just, you know what I'm saying? It was very monumental also because, you know, the way the ghost appeared.
Right. So what I did was certain angles that I tried to do to create the ghost. So first things first, this was my first time ever trying to do this. And it was really me trying to create the ghost effect. So what I did was I hopped on top of a chair and put a green screen behind me. What I did was I keyed out my background. I've morphed my face sort of and my whole body and try to make it like dissolve in certain angles. So you had the ghost try to appear in the doorway where it's, you know, he sees his, you know, the ghost, you know, sees the prey and then it just flows right into the door to the door slamming. What I also, the thing is, from when editing wise, we forgot to record the door ever slamming. So what I did was I took pictures of, before that, I took pictures of the door with the door wide open and then the door closed just to get different angles of what we needed from after the fact before we left. So what I did was I had to fake it. So the door was already open and I took another picture and I cut the door around the door and I had to keyframe it to where it can slide on its own really fast at a certain pace.
That nigga in that thing.
That scene right there was, you know, it was creating more, characterism with the cast and how they were talking with their different characters. Like, with Trell being the funny character and everybody else like reacting like, okay, they're doing too much and, you know, really putting more realism behind their character.
She was the most beautiful thing he ever saw and that he wanted to be with her. Bullshit.
First, I want to say this part right here, I think this day we had a photo shoot with the characters, right?
Yeah,
we had a photo shoot with the characters and, basically, what we just wanted to do was get pictures for posters, but us being the creative minds that we are, we decided to throw in an extra scene, a mystery scene that wasn't revealed to the cast yet. And this is the scene where I meet Layla in the hallway of the group home, and basically, this story just unfolds. So we just kind of threw this in last minute, and it came out perfect.
Yeah, so off the bat from the pictures, I wanted people of everybody to come out. Not everybody could come out. And we just immediately thought, yo, what if we, that's, you know, so we are just, you know, during a whole film of the movie, the one person that we had forgot to cast was supposed to be the ghost, Layla. So what we did was at the last minute, we asked Journey, which we had found just like weeks before then. We weren't certain about her for another character. But for this, I was like, I think maybe she could do this role. I'm just thinking. Again, we never seen any of these people acting. We were just hoping. Yeah. I know that's kind of reckless of us really doing that. But also, we were working with what we had. So, off the bat, we had her come to my house. And we had most of the cast and to really do these scenes was her meeting her. And from the story, it's unfolding. So, I think she was the one that came up with this idea to down the hallway, y'all hugging and, you know, the whole thing with the door. And also trapping them in to make it seem like, yo, let's do it backwards.
Because we was like, I think we said we should do a scene or something like that. Mm-hmm. And she came up with the idea of this whole scream. And so then we thought about, hey, we should, the irony of the story to increase it, we should actually act it out and push her in.
Wait, I was like, wait, where am I going?
So that's when that whole idea came about. and the fire in the bathroom came about, really pushing the story and really making it like, oh, you feel her pain. Like, this girl, that just, they pulled a prank on her and then just, it took it a whole different area. The fire started, nobody knew. They left her in there. Next thing you know, she was burned alive. And this whole thing.
Yeah.
And first things first, this that day that we had got her was the first day we have ever seen her at.
Open that door! Open that door!
And she already told us before then that she did theater. But off the bat, yo, when I seen this, away. Yo, I cannot believe her acting range from right there.
I was
that was
away.
Amazing.
I was blown away.
Help, please, please, let me, please.
This scene right here was monumental also because this was the scene where they found Morgan's body.
Morgan?
First things first off from effects wise. So what I did was I got Star to act like she was dead. Of course, we didn't want to get anything on the walls and nothing like that. Definitely wouldn't mess that up. So what I did was I had her pose as if she was all right, dead.
Three,
you know what I'm saying?
Two, and one.
I screenshot it. What I did was when I recorded her being dead, it didn't stay for that much long. So I had to screenshot it. And in Photoshop, I had to paint on the walls and paint some blood on her lips and cut around her eyes, make them seem like they was dead white. And really try to creep everybody out. And also, the other scenes where the lights was flickering. What I did was I had an LED light that I can control my phone, and I looked up in my room and I could control the flicker while I was making it seem like the house was being haunted and the power was being messed with. So initially what we wanted was, while Layla was talking with her old friends that betrayed her, what we wanted to do was have her distract them into calling Yamini for Yamini, the character that she's playing is Bree. So I had her come up to the TV, kind of touch the TV. She's trying to talk to Layla, but also have Layla try to possess through her body and take over her mind and her movements. So what I did was to have confirmation was have her eyes light up real bright. Now yes. Right here with Zay's scene, we didn't have any wires or anything to hold him up. So what we did was we had a green screen set up outside and we had him jump and pretend like he was being choked and kind of like rise up a little bit. And what I did was I had to try to mimic that movement of him being flown up in the air, but also he was standing on the green screen so you could see the wrinkles and everything. So I tried to cut it up in a certain place and then record him separately to have his body drop.
Hell of a job too.
What are we gonna do? So right here with the ghost appearance, so what I wanted to do was trap those two together. So by then, when they see the body, they wonder what they're doing. And in the corner of me creating the kind of demon of her in a certain way, I guess, like her shadow form, what I wanted to do is, the only way I could have done it, so I had me sit on the top of a green screen and had to try to mimic my movements of me holding onto the walls and also jumping out towards them and coming after them. But also having pretend like, yo, she closed the door on one of them and to trap them.
Creative genius.
First things first, either too, because we were in Airbnb, so we couldn't make no messes or anything, obviously. So what I did was, to make the blood come out of the floor, I had to cut around the door from under the door and also kind of create my own version of blood and have it fall through the floor and had to scale it up and time it right to move real slow past under. Now, first things first, what I did was from right here with her looking past, it's like she's seen the blood, noticing that he's dead. I had Jay in the other room pulling the door from open, but he couldn't be in the shot. So I had him slide from the other side of the room and just push the door real slow. And what I did was, again, have me on the green screen really looking and standing behind her. And also, there was no green screen behind her in this shot. So I had to cut around her whole body and her movement as she's walking back. It's real difficult.
Yeah. Like, you know, you're trying to pull it. I'm going to do a boom. You're going to jump. And
yeah,
then you see the blood on the floor.
All right, babe.
Yeah. Look on the floor. Slide the door, Jay.
we did was had the ghost of getting me walk forward towards the camera and also have her body being yanked. So what I had to do was kind of puppet around her on the green screen to kind of just have her body seem like it was being yanked. And I had to use 2D stock footage of glass breaking and also trying to make it seem like her body's being flown across the ground.
And it was, this was monumental to me also, because when we were writing this part, you know, we looked up the Airbnb before we started writing.
Yeah.
Just to get an idea of what we were working with. And the fact that it came out so perfect, we pictured her flying out the exact window that she flew out, and it was perfect.
Yeah.
It's perfect.
I know. Look, I know. Trust me. But what else can we do?
She wants a confession for something that was an accident. What do we do about that?
Bro.
I love this scene with you and Cherish. From right here, it's really seeing Cherish's range and the way how she's acting. Because I know she didn't really do much acting that I know of.
And it was just like, you know what I'm saying? Everything was on spot. Yeah. Everything was on spot.
I really love
Even this with scene. You, like,
yeah.
It's just, you know what I'm saying? You can tell the chemistry was all there.
Yeah.
What happened that night was an accident. No one started the fire.
It was me.
What?
I did it.
Why? Why did you start the fire, Crystal?
I was jealous. You were starting to take off with your artistic paying career, and your social media was blown up and loved by everybody. You were always loved by everybody, even in the group home.
Now, initially, them knowing that they had to leave, I wanted them to come downstairs, and she's there. She's waiting for them, waiting on the final part to reveal what the whole situation is to her. Seeing like, okay, like I have you where you want it, y'all might as well confess now.
Yeah.
So what we did, we told Cherish, go ahead and
go in,
confess
yeah.
to everything that you did, and also kind of manipulate with how we did with certain characters. So like with my character, we had them initially think like, oh, it was really kind of low key. They think like it's me.
Yeah.
But then we threw it to her. They're like, oh, but also.
The whole movie, she was denying it.
Right.
But she knew the whole time, you know. And just her monologue, it was such a moving monologue because, you know, us not even knowing that she was going to do this well, it, like, to me, while we were filming, I was just looking at her like, man, like, yo, she's really killing it, bro. Yeah. It was just so peaceful, not peaceful, but so...
natural movement.
Natural movement, the way she said it.
After all this time, you knew...
Come on, bitch. I thought she did it. While we were recording this part specifically, Cherish's monologue was perfect. The way she conducted her monologue, it was just like, and me not knowing like how her acting skills really were, you know what I'm saying? Never acting with her, never, you know what I'm saying? It was just amazing to see her like work right there in front of me. Like, wow! Like,
for somebody that does not have really no experience with acting, like she outdid herself. Just,
she knocked it out the park.
Yeah, she really outdid herself. Cherish did her thing.
And then Yamini's part after Cherish confessed.
So it's her too. Right. So it's now not only from Layla seeing that okay, like I already knew who did it, but now I want you to confess to everybody like what you did. And automatically, she's inside of Bree's body. So what she does, she lets Bree come out to really see, like, oh, her friends really did this to their friend that they really liked and trust. And to
that
her,
just made her emotion right. come out even more.
So now she's upset, and she's very, like, she's real pissed to Layla being coming out and really giving her final moment. Right, so initially, after everybody had confessed, and Bree is sort of, she, you know, she's real pissed that her friends really portrayed their own, their good friend before that they have really entrusted and really played with her throughout that whole traumatic experience.
Layla snapped back.
Yeah, so Layla snapped back and she really let loose on how she was feeling. You know, her getting pushed into the closet and her burning in, she wanted to return that favor and
make her feel what she felt. Right. That's how we basically wanted to do this scene.
Yeah. Like, let me show you how I feel. You understand? And really created the same thing. So we had our good friend Journey really pushed her back into, you know, this closet, also setting her on fire inside her own mind, really messing with her own mind. And messing with her mind as she is, we had her also, her nose bleeding and sort of effect, and really, we glowed her eyes from like a reflection in the fire in her mind, and really having like a, you know, her just sitting there.
It was me.
What? Why, nigga? Oh, I'm waiting for her to snap this shit. I'm waiting.
I'm sorry, I gotta go right back into it. Cause like my favorite scene out the whole movie is this.
You're not the only one, bro. You're not the only one. This right here, that little, I was like, yes, bitch. Then, get his ass.
Then he was like,
yeah. Like, well, let's relax. Take it down a
notch. This took me some stuff to edit. Because, like,
that's a lot going on there. Yeah, I can really see how.
Right, because we got Journey to be right here with this green screen that we threw behind her. And I think that was the same day we had did all those scenes with her. First time really seeing her act. Mm-hmm. And she outdid herself. And
yes. Blew it out the park.
And for her, I was like, yo, let's do this part where it's like, you're trying to get revenge on me, but also, like, you're trying to blow the fire back at me and also reveal your true form. Mm-hmm. So, like, I had to, of course, green screen, I had to try to, like, put some burn marks on her body.
Yeah, and have it try to move gore somewhere. And everything in there.
Yeah, it was perfect.
And the picture of the Airbnb was at was on the website. Mm-hmm. So, what I had to do was get some fire, try to, like, put it all around. Like, she's spreading it around the house. What I did was I had to 3D track in different places around the house, and she was on the green screen, so I had to get fire from Action VFX. That's a good website to get 2D effects. So what I did was I had some fire, put it around to also make it seem like it was glowing in the back and shadows, and the curtains being fire and her lit up, and like the effect of her pushing it is really crazy. It was really amazing though. That was my, I think that was the best VFX shot I ever did.
That was, when I seen that, I was so, I couldn't even believe it, man. It's just the way the fire is moving in all directions. Mm-hmm. Like, you can really tell you really did your thing on this part. Yeah.
I think this is my favorite shot out the whole movie.
And then I also like how, you know, this part right here, we really wanted to portray her as, oh yeah, you guys thought you were going to get away with this. Mm-hmm. Look at me. Look how I am.
Yeah.
I'm going to return the favor to you guys.
Right. So, obviously, when we thought about this, I didn't initially think of her being burned. I didn't think of it. So, it was kind of hard to try to burn her clothes when they really weren't burned. And the kind of editing that I was doing at the time. Also had her really showing her whole true form, so we had her scars heal and sort of away, and then Sheila gives her the same pain that she had felt towards my character. Right. So even with the with him calling the police around this time, it was during daytime. All of this is during daytime, so I still try to make sure to make it seem like it was nighttime. So I put a moon in the bottom, like in the top corner, and try to have that reflection. Also him calling 911. And who he thinks is Bree coming out to really give herself. And, you know, she's feeling sad that all her friends just got killed just now. Really? And then really it's Layla playing along.
Still in possession of her body.
Right. So for a moment she goes after him last, because he's initially the main one that called, that lured her to the closet. And initially we wanted a few people killed and some people alive, but he thought of having everybody killed. Die. Right.
I don't know what made me feel like, I feel like everybody should die, but I feel like, you know, most stories end with that one person being alive. Mm-hmm. I just feel like, you know what, I want to do something different. How about everybody die? Mm-hmm. You know, everybody had a part in the fire, so everybody pays, you know? Mm-hmm. And that just would made the most sense.
Right. So after when she comes out and she manipulates him to thinking, oh yeah, that's Bree, when it's really Layla. We wanted her to automatically just kill him, because he's the one that pretty much lured her towards the closet and causing this whole mess. And then from what everybody thought at a certain moment, that Bree was Bree after she snaps back and she realizes what, you know, all her friends are dead, like, that really just happened right in front of her, to Layla also killing her too, as calling the retribution. Pure revenge off leaving no remorse and just letting it go like that.
And that's a wrap on retribution.
Yes, sir!
We're done.
So, you know, me and KJ, we've been doing this for, what, 8 years?
Mm-hmm.
8 years. So, you know, when we stepped into the film industry, you know, our first film, we didn't even expect it to do 75K. You know, it just took off. So, you know, with our next movie, Retribution, we wanted to do something a little bit different, you know. Our dream is to potentially make it into Hollywood. So, you know, we thought about, you know what? Why not have a premiere? So, you know, at first it was a vision. We knew what it was going to take to set the premiere up and do all this. And right now, while we're in the pandemic, we knew it was going to also be hard. But, you know, through stressful days and nights of planning, you know, we made it happen. Met this lady. She let us run her place. Very nice. I want to shout out L&L Events. Thank you again for letting us use your place. I want to thank everybody who also came out and participated, because, you know, we set a goal of how many tickets we wanted to sell due to the pandemic. And we sold out. We sold out our very first event. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, red carpet event. It was beautiful.
Yeah, it was.
It was. The cast members showed up looking beautiful. You know, their families, friends came through. I want to also shout out my boy DJ Conflicted. Eddie, I appreciate you, man, for coming through on that. You know, it was a very nice event, man. What do you want to say?
Yeah, we, you know, just initially wanted everybody to really just show out. You know, this is everybody's. Even I, by the time I finished editing, I never showed Jay. Yeah. Only just like pieces, a little bit of pieces, not the whole thing of what the movie would look like. So this was also his first reaction.
Hey, you know what time it is.
So not everybody from the cast could come that night, but we still got some in. Everybody really enjoyed themselves and everything like that. We want everybody to, you know, come in with their friends and, you know, families and everything, and still keep everything spread out due to COVID. And, you know, starting it off, we initially, a week or two before then, we planned to announce our next projects. So we thought of a way to, let's just throw in some trailers before, you know, like a real movie theater, throw in our own trailers, revealing our next projects, and shouting out from our label, Stack It Up Entertainment, from my CEO.
Stack It Up Entertainment, CEO, yeah. Best CEO out there.
This is 64.
Shout out 64.
Yeah.
It's my opportunity.
It was
a wonderful event, you know. We plan on having a premiere for each movie, but you know what I'm saying, we gotta see what's in the plans, but you know, it was a very good event.
Without y'all, we couldn't do this.
Actually, man.
Oh, I was Jay Jones. I'm Brent Rich. We are Rizalex. And Blinded is about a girl in an abusive relationship grows fond of one of her classmates. Right now, that has about 65,000 views on YouTube. Recently, we put our heads together and decided to make a horror short film called Retribution. Retribution is about 8 friends taking a vacation on the 30th anniversary of a fire that occurred at a group home, and the vacation reconnects with their past. I hope you enjoy.
He's so anti.
I'm nervous.
Leave him alone.
I appreciate everybody coming out.
You did that.
You know, everything going on in the world right now, I feel like this is something that we really need to get up. Yeah. You know, it's all positive vibes. Anybody that has some bad going through, leave that out the door. This is all, you know, some good time.
Yeah.
So, for anybody that don't have the last minute thing, we got like over 100 masks back there. We got some popcorn, sodas, and drinks back there. Y'all, they each bring them right there. Before we start though, we're gonna show you a few projects that we got planned for next year. And we have a few celebrities that you might recognize that shout out from my CEO from Stack It Up Entertainment. Where's he at right now?
There you
go! Yes!
Yeah, so before we start, I'm going to show y'all a few projects that we got planned for next year. And you saw that big shout out to CEO's name, but they were inside the movie. All of them, it's about 30 minutes. So you be in and out of here, go home, watch Netflix, do something, you know? Stay back, it's Friday, you know?
Y'all
sound
sad now.
If y'all want popcorn, we got popcorn in the back. And after the movie's over, y'all want to take pictures, go ahead, do y'all thing. Thank y'all.
My cousin did his thing on that movie, man. KJ, y'all go tune in. Tough.
This is getting good. Bro. Look, bro. Bro, this is so good. Oh my God.
Hey, I just finished watching the movie Retribution by my boys. Yo, that nigga KJ, the next Spike Lee. My biscuit head brother, Jay Jones. Y'all did y'all thing, bruh.
Deadass hooked off just the preview. Let me go watch this. Y'all know what y'all doing. Let me go watch this. I don't want to spoil it for y'all, but this part making me mad, okay? I'm proud of Layla. Layla came back and got her revenge. She did what she had to do, but she wowed out. Like, oh my gosh, that was so good.
So, when I watched Retribution the other day, the first thing I thought was, yo, this shit is really good, especially for a first start on a horror movie. Like, it was really good. The other thing that really excited me to know is that, you know, that's my boy from around the way doing his thing, directing, acting, and he doing his thing with his cousins. He doing his thing with his friends and everybody he know, and it's just, you talking about a dude that went from making things Harry Potter-esque to doing his own thing, writing his own scripts. Just to see that movie and be part of that movie was really heavy for a nigga. And I mean that shit to the sincerest form of flattery. That movie was really good. Kareem, deadass dude, all of y'all keep doing your thing. I'm proud of all y'all. That shit was putting RVA on the map. Keep doing what you're doing. God bless all of y'all, dude.
I want to give thanks to the whole cast. The whole cast.
Everybody.
Everybody. From a whole, most of the cast that had never acted before, they really did their thing in this movie. I have seen them reenact certain scenes throughout their voice and how they were doing from FaceTime calls and them on a rehearsal really doing it and also clicking instantly. I never met a group of people that can click like that so instantly to really get along with everybody.
It was just amazing for us as the directors and writers to actually see this come to life.
Yeah.
It was just amazing because, you know, it's different on paper. It's different on a computer, you know what I'm saying? But when it's time to actually shoot, it was just amazing to see everybody just show what they really had, you know? Mm-hmm. And, yeah, we just want to thank the whole cast. Everybody, want to give a shout out to RJ.
Yeah,
for that song, man. Y'all go check him out too. We gonna put his information.
Mm-hmm.
Also want to thank Jacquees.
Yeah,
your song was amazing. Also,
yeah.
We just want to thank everybody for supporting us through this and helping us out, shouting us out, and all that, because this isn't easy. You know, this is a very stressful, but it's also fun at the same time. But you know, it takes a lot of hard work. It's not easy.
You know, some people might think, hey, I can do that too. You could, but it's not easy. I'm trying to tell you, it's not easy at all.
And given the opportunity from the first film that we did that I had wrote, but it was our first film, like, ever.
Yeah.
It was just initially a school project. For it to be thrown up on YouTube just to take off how it did, like, unexpectedly. And then given this opportunity from our CEO to have our opportunity to promote our work onto a major music platform that was made for famous artists.
Vivo.
And really to be able to get us on Roku and Tidal, that's a real blessing.
That's a blessing. Oh, Lord of God.
Thank you again, Mr. Our CEO, stacking up.
Yeah. But we just want to thank everybody for supporting us, everybody in the cast. We want to thank the people who let us use the Airbnb. We just want to thank everybody, you know. And we got some more coming soon. Deceptive? Oh, yeah. Coming soon. But we just want to thank everybody, you know, for supporting Risen Legacy. Thank you from the bottom of our heart.
Yeah.
Chill with it. So you're posting that nigga now?
Oh, you shut up on your phone and see, like, you shut it.
Yeah.
Put
on my phone some shit like.
And cut. Period. Period. Yes. Don't need no more scenes.
Oscar?
Oscar? I'm saying.
Don't shut the door.
So like when you.
Yeah, like that. So like you can't get the door when you. Boom. You know what I'm saying?
Alright. All right. 1, 2, 3, action.
We're gonna stop on top again.
Go ahead, top.
What the fuck? Did you see what she did?
What?
Bro, she just said.
Yeah.
Out the sky. Killed that bitch. Out the sky. That bitch said.
Girls just watch these things. Like,
he got another baby on the way. He real funny.
That's a lot of people. Wow, you could guess that.
Nah. The boy is getting pregnant.
From the start of the jump, we was like, oh. Now at the end of the jump, we like, hey. But look though,
Watch more on the robbery at the Blackwood House this morning, later this evening. Also, we want to remind all of our viewers of the mysterious...
What the heck? I'm trying to make sure I don't get it in the frame.
Man, you look like you were trying to shoot me with a BB gun.
Let me show you.
It's the skin for me. Oh my god.
I don't know what it's at.
Wait, you got best
friend. Yeah, we got the thing.
Retribution, you already know what the fuck going on. Hey,
getting the Oscar.
Hey, look. Don't take us lightly. This right here is just the beginning. Yeah. Wait, we already started. Now we just see, I'm rapping in this joint, and I'm rapping like I'm Dennis, and I'm Dennis to Menace, and what I'm in fuck? It to win it. And you know I got my friends, and they in it to win it. But it's okay. Risen Legacy go here, and we say to say that. Eh?
Let me see that light. Let me turn it off. Yo.
If she got good head, I buy a Sonic slushy, but I can't give her no money. Ooh. Throw it back like a pro bitch. Yeah. Pop that pussy like a faux bitch. Get that bag, middle fingers up to a broke bitch.
Like club guard say, throw that ass, poke it out. I ain't gay, but.
Girl got a big ass motherfucking back. And she look like a motherfucking snack.
Yeah, that shit was tired.
Hey, that's fucking. Yeah. Shoot it rest of the scene. Let's go. I go off on my team.
That's acting, you feel me? She do that shit.
I try my best.
She be doing that dancing shit too.
I try my best.
That Dougie and shit, Nene. Fuck no. Fuck no.
I want senior superlative besties 7 times in a row.
I'm saying, like, we won't even
say seventh grade. Like, what you talking about?
Seventh grade.
Y'all ready?
Always in the year. Oh, yeah. Always. You know who you're talking to?
Huh?
You know who you're talking to?
I already know
the
you.
The besties of the rest.
Period. I love to hear it.
Okay.
Oh.
We finna film this, John. You know what I'm saying? It's about to go stoop.
No, I'm joking.
Hey, action. Yeah. Yeah. Man. Oh, yeah.
This is small as hell.
Don't blame me. Mike put Trey dumbass in charge.
Bruh, I mean, honestly, if it makes it any better, y'all just had a couch on the floor. Bruh. I mean,
Hell no.
I don't think he ever saw her and that he wanted to be with her. Bullshit, for real.
No,
Kevin?
I mean,
bro.
What?
Bro, bro.
I'm Kevin.
Alright, one more time. Come on.
Alright.
Bring that cookie.
Rachel!
I'm gonna put you on.
Alright, action.
That nigga, come on.
Alright.
You gotta say retribution number?
One.
No, say retribution on three.
Okay. Retribution on three. Retribution on three. One, two, three. Retribution.
I just got the hands. That was it.
Oh. Oh.